Oral epithelium forms the primary barrier between the oral environment and deeper tissues. Oral epithelium is of two types depending on the functional requirement: stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium and stratified squamous keratinized epithelium. The keratinized epithelium can be further divided into orthokeratinized epithelium and parakeratinized epithelium. Here we will discuss the stratified squamous keratinized epithelium. The structural integrity of an epithelium is maintained by the continuous cell renewal, in which cells are produced by mitotic divisions in the deeper layer, which then migrate to the surface while undergoing maturation, and after reaching the surface, shed off. Turnover rate is the time taken by the cell in the deepest layer to divide and pass through the entire epithelium. This divides the cells of the oral epithelium into two populations. First, the progenitor population, whose function is to divide and provide new cells. Second is the maturing population, which continuously undergoes differentiation or maturation, also known as keratinization. Desquamation is the term given when the cells after reaching the topmost layer shed off. Stratified squamous keratinized epithelium has four layers: basal layer, spinous layer, granular layer and cornified layer, or as they are more commonly known by their Latin names, stratum basale, stratum spinosum, stratum granulosum, stratum corneum. Structurally, epithelial cells are mononuclear, have intercellular bridges called desmosomes, and have characteristic fibrous proteins called cytokeratins in the cytoplasm. It is these cytokeratins because of which epithelial cells are called as keratinocytes. Stratum basale. Stratum basale is the deepest layer attached to the basal membrane. Basal cells are cuboidal to columnar cells and have hyperchromatic nucleus. These cells are rich in cell organelles and undergo repeated mitotic divisions. This layer is responsible for the continuous supply of new keratinocytes and is therefore also referred to as stratum germinativum. Stratum spinosum. Stratum spinosum is the layer above the stratum basale and is the thickest layer. The cells in this layer are larger than basal cells and are polygonal in shape. The cells show minute cytoplasmic extensions, which gives them a spiny appearance or prickly appearance. This is because during tissue preparation for microscopic analysis, due to dehydration, the cells shrink, but being attached to each other at the desmosomes, they produce cytoplasmic extensions maintaining the intercellular junction. Among all the layer, this layer is most active in protein synthesis for production of cytokeratins. Stratum granulosum. The cells in this layer are larger than the spinous cells. They are flatter and wider in shape. The nucleus starts showing signs of degeneration or pycnosis. The cells appear granular due to the presence of the keratohyalin granules, which are 0.5 to 1 nanometer in size and are rich in filaggrin proteins. These proteins are responsible for aggregation and formation of crosslinks between the cytokeratin filaments, forming bundles. This provides strength to the epithelium. Other than keratohyalin granules, there are odelin bodies or membrane coating granules. These granules are not proteins but glycolipids, and they release their contents outside the cells in the intercellular space. They help in forming a lipid-rich permeability barrier that limits movement of aqueous substances through the intercellular spaces. Additionally, proteins like involucrin and loricrin start depositing just beneath the cell membranes to form a cornified cell envelope, which provides high mechanical resistance. All these changes in the granular layer transforms the keratinocyte to a mechanically resistant top layer, stratum corneum. If we compare orthokeratinized and parakeratinized epithelium, granular layer is more prominent in orthokeratinized epithelium as compared to that in parakeratinized epithelium. This leads to the higher extent of keratinization seen in orthokeratinized epithelium than parakeratinized epithelium. Stratum corneum. This is the topmost layer of the epithelium. The cells in this layer are larger than the granular cells. They are flatter and appear squamous in shape. These cells cannot synthesize any proteins. This is because the nucleus undergoes complete degeneration. The cytoplasm is dehydrated and densely packed with cross-linked cytokeratins. These cells finally shed off by the process of desquamation. If we compare orthokeratinized and parakeratinized epithelium, in orthokeratinized epithelium, complete degeneration of nucleus takes place, whereas in parakeratinized epithelium, only partial degeneration of nucleus takes place, so that the degenerating nucleus is seen as a shrunken nucleus or pycnotic nucleus. So we see, as the epithelial cells undergo maturation and move through the various epithelial layers, all the changes taking place in the keratinocytes are to produce a keratinized top layer which makes the epithelium strong, an essential requirement in the masticatory mucosa.